grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father, from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. The text for our message this morning comes from our second reading. We hear them telling in our own tongues the mighty works of God. And all were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" These are the words of our Lord that we will meditate upon this morning, this Pentecost day, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. On this Pentecost day, when we have once again been confounded and confronted by images of tongues of fire, the sound of mighty rushing winds, miraculous events are abounding. The Holy Spirit now focuses us not upon the wow, but upon the word. Because you see, the Spirit of God chooses to work through God's saving word. The word that was spoken that day was spoken clearly, miraculously, but also in a way so that everyone, no matter what their background, no matter what their nationality, could hear and be amazed by the mighty works of God. And there were many mighty works of God that Pentecost day. The first mighty work of God, of course, was the coming of the Holy Spirit, just as Jesus had promised. After his resurrection, before his ascension into heaven, Jesus commanded his disciples, "Behold, I am sending the promise of my Father upon you. Stay in the city until you are clothed with power from on high." You see, Jesus knew that his disciples on their own were not up to the task that he was to give them. Jesus knew that the work of God must be done by God. And so the Son had come, and he had worked the redemption of all of mankind by sacrificing his sinful life for ours, ransoming every single lost soul from sin, and then rising again from death to prove that his work was complete and sufficient. In doing this, the Father's perfect will had been done. And now the Holy Spirit comes, and he clothed the faithful with power from on high. And so now God is continuing to do the work by the means that he has chosen, by the means that he has always worked, by his powerful word prophesied, spoken for him, by those whom he chooses, whom he equips, whom he empowers and sends. And so the next mighty work on that great Pentecost day was the fulfillment of the prophecy of Joel that God had given hundreds of years before, that Peter now proclaims anew, saying, "On my male servants and on my female servants in those days, I will pour out my spirit and they will prophesy." And that is exactly what they began to do. Now the thing is, though, we have lost the meaning, the true meaning of that word prophesy, the biblical meaning. Because in our common language today, when people hear the word prophesy, they mean something like being able to tell the future. But what the word actually means, according to Scripture, to speak for another, or to proclaim or interpret a divine revelation. So what Joel foresaw and spoke about was now happening there in Jerusalem that day. The mighty work of God was this: to use ordinary men and women to proclaim the extraordinary message of salvation in Jesus. Now imagine being an apostle that day, or anybody else in that upper room. You would have been very tempted to get lost in this miraculous gift that they had been given, to focus their attention on the messenger, the Holy Spirit, instead of the message, Jesus Christ. And it is still a temptation that many people fall into today, to get so wound up about the Holy Spirit and all the crazy things that they say come from Him that they miss Jesus, which is what it's all about. Because Jesus is the one who took our sins upon Himself. Jesus is the one who came to pay the price that we could never pay. Jesus is the one who is the God-man, who came to save us even when we did not want to be saved, and who still comes doing the same thing today. You see, the Holy Spirit never desires that our attention be focused upon Him over Jesus. No, the Holy Spirit always and only points to Jesus, Him alone, as our means of salvation. Jesus told His disciples this: when the Helper comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, He will bear witness about Me. And so also the apostles are now taking that witness and passing it on to fulfill what Jesus also said to them, and you also will bear witness, because you have been with Me from the beginning. My friends, the mighty work and act of God is not to use ongoing, miraculous revelations and signs, but to use people indwelt by the Holy Spirit, armed with the Word of God, spoken, written, and in the means of grace, the sacraments, to bring to people their salvation in Jesus Christ as a gift. And this has to be the mighty act of God, because we don't want to be saved. We let sin. Amen? We revel in sin. Plus, you know, we're spiritually dead too, right? We can't save ourselves, even if we wanted to. And we don't. So God must do it. And God does it through the Holy Spirit and His means of the gospel. That is the word and not the wow of the first Pentecost. Because if you continue to read the account of Pentecost in Acts, after what you have already heard this morning in our reading, Peter goes on to give a Holy Spirit inspired law and gospel sermon about Jesus. He preaches the law about how we killed Jesus by our sin. And then he preaches the gospel about how Jesus did not stay dead, but rose to prove that the price He paid for us was paid in full. Then he preaches that Jesus Christ has now risen and He is ascended and He sits at the right hand, the almighty, powerful place of authority with His Father. And that all of His enemies and all of your enemies of sin, death, and hell are now nothing more than His footstool. And he preaches that all of these mighty acts of God are for us. And they culminate in these beautiful words: know for certain, you who hear these mighty words of God, that God has made Jesus Christ both Lord and Christ, the Jesus whom you crucified. That was Pentecost. That was that first mighty day some 2,000 years ago. But you know what? This is great news this morning, folks. The mighty works of God are not just in the past. They are also ongoing. They are around us. They are in us. These mighty acts of God are still there for us to recall. They are still there for us to proclaim to our children, to our children's children, to everyone who is around us. Here are God's mighty works that are still here for you to share. God works mightily through the preaching of the word of the cross. Such preaching is powerful because God is working and not us. In the book of Acts, you see it time and time and time again. Peter and the others simply proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, and then by the power of the Holy Spirit, thousands come to faith at one time, and they are baptized into the name of the triune God. Where God wills and how He wills. God works mightily also through the word and the waters of holy baptism. In this miraculous washing away of sins, we are given forgiveness, we are given faith, we are made children of the Heavenly Father, we are given the gift of the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. God works mightily through the word that proclaims that this bread and wine is the body and blood of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And again, the Holy Spirit works faith within our hearts and our souls to believe Jesus' mighty and powerful works, that this bread and this wine does indeed forgive you your sins. It does strengthen your faith. It does give you the grace to live a God-pleasing life, that this is for we sinners to eat and to drink. Thereby we receive the Lord Jesus Christ in the most intimate and personal way, and yet also in the most unifying corporate way, along with the whole body of Christ, who believe without reservation, without any human sophistry, the plain truth that Jesus has given us of His Holy Supper. We receive forgiveness of sins, strength and faith. God's mighty work among us again here this morning. And God's mighty work comes to us through His simple word. But it is the Spirit of God working through that word that assures us of our salvation, that empowers us to confess the faith that He has given to us in our daily lives. It is God's word that is powerful, not us. It is God's word that does the work of bringing Christ to people and people to Christ. And so God's saving work works. His word works, even when it is delivered by the quite ordinary. The great miracle and majesty of God's plan of spreading the message of salvation in Jesus Christ is that the Spirit rests on us. All of us. Ordinary people. Remember the reading? It said the Spirit was given to all in the house. And so it is today. The Spirit is given to all in the house. All believers who have come to faith in Jesus Christ by the power of the Spirit are given the Spirit equally today. There are no first-class and second-class Christians in the church. Definitely not here at Trinity. Now, we have been given different gifts, different talents, different vocations, different offices. But they are all to be used in the service of God and His kingdom, But we are, each and every one of us, empowered by the exact same faith, the exact same Spirit of God. So don't be afraid. Do not be afraid. Do not be apprehensive about your work in the kingdom. Because it is the Holy Spirit of God that gives to us ordinary people the words that we need to confess the faith. And those words are the Word of God in His Holy Scripture. So remember this very important truth today. The testimony that we give must never be about us, but always about our Lord Jesus Christ. He places people into our lives who need to hear that message of Jesus Christ, and He equips us with the Word. But you got to crack the Word, folks. He will equip you and He will empower you as you diligently study that Word. Read, learn, inwardly digest, and outwardly confess that powerful Word. And He empowers us to meet the people that we need to meet. And we meet them right where they are. And we give to them exactly what they need, the saving gospel of Jesus Christ. And as we are faithful to that calling, God promises that the Holy Spirit will do as He wills with His mighty power. New people who were formerly lost in sin will, by the power of the Holy Spirit working through that Word, be enabled now to call upon the name of the Lord and be saved. That is the true wow of Pentecost, because it comes from the Word. God is the master craftsman. We are the tools in His hand. We have been given His Spirit, His Word, His church. The mighty works of God continue to save. So as we have been filled by the Holy Spirit, so may we